So far, we've seen how to examine a variable's distribution using histograms and how to check our hunches with visualizations and numerical summaries. But there's another type of plot that lets us compare distributions, and it's called the frequency polygon. Frequency polygons are similar to histograms, but they draw a curve connecting the counts in a histogram. So this allows us to see the shape and the peaks of our distribution in more detail. You might remember from before that we were looking at friend count using this code. This code gave us a histogram of our users' friend counts, and then we added a facet wrap and broke it out by gender. Remember, we were trying to answer the question, who on average has more friends, men or women? We said we couldn't tell based on this histogram, so we ran some numerical summaries instead. And instead of having these two histograms side by side, we can actually use a frequency polygon and overlay these histograms together. Here's how we can create that frequency polygon. I'll copy and paste the same code, except I need to make an addition. By default, qplot's going to create a histogram when I pass it just one single variable, so I need to tell it to create a frequency polygon instead. I can use the geom parameter to do that. Here, I'll pass it frequency polygon, so that way we create a different type of plot. And I won't need this facet wrap by gender anymore. To get the distributions of each gender on the plot, I'm going to pass the parameter color to qplot and set it equal to gender. So here's my color parameter, and now I'm going to pass it gender. When I run this code, I get one plot with two frequency polygons, one for males and one for females. And notice how gender is being assigned to color, so color is indicating which frequency polygon I'm on. And this is what the frequency polygon is really good for. We can compare two or more distributions at once. But again, this plot doesn't really answer our question, who has more friends on average, men or women? Let's change the y-axis to show proportions instead of raw counts. This is going to involve some funky syntax, so I want to explain it. To change this count variable, we're going to pass in y to our qplot function. I'm going to assign the parameter y this expression. This allows me to get proportions instead of the actual raw counts on the y-axis. And I'm just going to move this around so that way my code looks a little bit cleaner. And finally, let me change the labels to more accurately explain the plot. All right, it looks like I have everything. Let's run this code and see the differences. Zooming in on the plot, we can see that we've changed the y-axis scale, and we have our labels appearing here and here. And while it may appear that males have higher friend counts on average than women, we can see that many males, or a high percentage of them, have low friend counts. It's probably in this tail region of the graph where females overtake males. I encourage you to play around with this yourself in our studio to see where women overtake men in this side of the x-axis. Try using limits or try using breaks to explore more. We've learned some new syntax here, so let's see if you can put it into practice. Your task is to determine which gender creates more likes on the World Wide Web. To answer that question, I want you to create a frequency polygon and explore it in many different ways. Remember that the first plot you make doesn't need to be final. I want you to create a couple of plots and make adjustments to the limits and the breaks on the x-axis until you're satisfied.